Welcome to our tutorial. In this video, we will talk about using scenes in a visualization project and focus on the difference between a classic ANX scene and a ThinkNX scene. The definition of scene in the automation world is a combination of pre-configured actions on different ANX actuators that can be launched normally from a push button. A scene can combine multiple functions such as lights, shutters, HVAC and more. In a classic ANX installation, the integrator must enable the use of scene on every single desired output, which can be time-consuming. It even becomes a big hassle to add or remove elements to the scene, especially when the project is finished. In addition, there is a limitation on the allowed number of scenes for each ANX device, and it usually depends on each brand. Also, it's not always possible to have customized pauses between the actions. With a ThinkNX project, all scenes can be configured inside the configurator without the need to do anything in the ETS project. The integrator can create an unlimited number of scenes, and any addition to the scene can be introduced remotely or by the end user himself. In addition, a ThinkNX scene is not only limited to KNX commands, but it can also contain actions from other systems and protocols such as multimedia and alarm. The end user can also choose to add a delay between two consecutive actions inside the scene and edit its duration. When configuring the project, you can create a button to launch a normal scene or link it to a ThinkNX scene. In the next section, we will show you how to configure both types. First, let's start with the ThinkNX scene. Go to the page where you would like to add your button, click on Add, and select the scene object. Go to the properties to the right and label the button. Under Scenery Object, you will find an empty list. That's because the scenery object must be created in System first. To do so, click on the System tab, then System, and right-click to add a scene. In the properties, start by labeling the object. If you wish to launch this scene from a KNX keypad, then create a new KNX address and use it on your push button. You can configure your group address as a 1-bit or a 1-byte object, depending on your installation requirements. If you select 1-bit, you can choose to decide what values will trigger the scene. If you select 1-byte, then you only need to enter the scene number. In case you are only controlling the scene from the mobile application, then you may leave the KNX group empty. The record parameter, if enabled, will allow the client to record his own scene using the application. If you wish to remove that option and create your own list of actions, then disable this parameter and proceed to the list of actions. The restartable parameter is useful when you have long pauses in between actions, and it allows the scene to be triggered after being launched. You may leave it disabled, especially when you are launching the scene from KNX, to avoid Telegram's repetition. By accessing the list of actions, you can start adding the scene actions and save them into the project. Click on Add, select your first action and rename it, then click on the command to open the internal commands window and configure your action. As you can see, the option is not limited to KNX only. Going back to the scene, you can also change the time in between actions and configure a group address to send the scene status to the bus. The value will be 1 when the scene is running and 0 when the scene is completed. Now that we've created our scenery object, the final step would be to link it to our icon. By choosing again the scenery object parameter, we will be able to see the scene created in system and select it. You can change the image of your scene icon by going to Custom Images. You can choose to select an image from the existing library, or decide to import your own art. Each scene has a label which is hidden by default under Text parameter. You can make it visible by selecting the position of the text. The remaining parameters are common to most objects in the interface. You can scale your icon or change its position. You can also choose to have a visible background and configure it as pleased. If you do not wish to view this icon in portrait mode, then disable the view in list. It is possible to link the icon to a pin created in the system tab or restrict some users from viewing this icon altogether by going into restrictions and selecting the allowed users only. Once you finish your configuration and upload the project to the client's device, you can now test your icon. When clicking the scene icon, a window will open, through which the user is able to launch the scene, rename it, record it, or access the actions list to edit it. The record button is only clickable if the option was enabled inside the configurator. When recording a scene, a red frame will appear around the interface allowing the user to browse through the pages and start adding actions to the scene. It is important to note that the icons which are not pressed will not be part of the scene. If the users do not wish to send the commands to the bus while recording, they can click on the bottom right corner icon to enable/disable this feature. Clicking on the bottom left corner of the screen will save and exit the recording mode. When accessing the Actions button, the user is able to record additional actions in the scene, add a pause in between them, select multiple ones and rearrange their order or delete them. When recording additional actions, the red frame will appear again around the interface to allow the user to browse through the pages and configure the state of the buttons to be included in the scene. Once finished, the user should click on the bottom red circle to save the changes. The next part of this video is dedicated to the classic ANX scene. If you already have one configured in your ETS project, you can simply add a button to play the scene from your interface. To do so, go to your page, click on Add, and select the generic command. Rename your button, and click on Command to configure it. From there, select System, then send KNX by Telegram. Enter your scene group address, followed by your scene number. Select an image for your icon, and customize the button as desired. For a more complex button, with short and long press options, we will have to use the extended command. Click on Add, and select the extended command. We will configure this button to play the scene on short press, and record it on long press. First, rename your icon. Then, under KNX group, enter the group address you will be using for your KNX scene. This means that your data type should be a 1-byte unsigned. Click on Feedback States. A window will open where you will see two states, State 0 and State Middle. You can delete State Middle since you are not using this button for multiple states such as Toggle. Select State 0 and rename it. Under Image for State, select the image you want to have on the icon. Click on Command to open the command window and configure the short press action. Select System, send KNX by Telegram, and fill the scene group address and scene number. Close the command window and enable the hold press function to enable the long press. Open the command window, and select System, send KNX by Telegram. Enter the scene group address and the value to record it. Thank you for watching. If you require further information, please visit our wiki page or send us your support request on the links shown on the screen, and remember to subscribe to our channel for future videos.